2008 was an unprecedented time in America. The unemployment rate had risen to 7.3%, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average had experienced days of volatility. But in the midst of those uncertain times, the air of jubilation was felt throughout the country because America had just elected its first black chief executive, making Barack Obama the 44th president of the United States. Change had also come to the Apostolic Church of God. Bishop Arthur M. Brazier had appointed his son, Dr. Byron T. Brazier, the pastor and shepherd of Apostolic, and the era of truth to trust was about to unfold. As the new leader of Apostolic Church of God, Dr. Brazier continued building on the church's foundation and legacy, while at the same time charting a new course as it relates to what ministry would look like and how it would be done.
He had to step into these huge shoes, and one thing that I remember him saying is that I want to be a pastor of the same kind. And that means to me that he's going to be just as large in life as Bishop was, but in his own way, because there's only one Bishop, but there's also only one Dr. Brazier.
His vision for the church and how he saw ministry in the church was very instrumental in how he kind of ushered us to this point. He was introducing us to different concepts that we hadn't done before under Bishop, like prayer service. That was very unique, where there was no sermon. There was sermonettes, but the whole congregation got prayed for on a Sunday. Never done anything like that before.
Being the pastor of a mega church came with blessings and challenges. It would take a bold and tenacious visionary to lead Apostolic through all the things that lie ahead. The advancement of technology was a vehicle to help the Apostolic Church of God to continue to remain a beacon of light, as the message still had to reach people, and Dr. Brazier took the message of God to the global stage by way of the internet.
The pandemic truly stretched the bounds of our intellect. We used technology in order to try to make sure that the word of God got to the people of God.
I just want to thank the Lord for each and every one of you and those who are watching by a live stream, those who are watching our broadcast.
We are online, on our website, on the internet, on the social media platforms. That's additional exposure that your church has, and the word of God that he preaches every Sunday goes out to reach those who may not physically be here. So the vision continues to grow.
The church had grown and new church homes had been built over the years to accommodate the membership. Dr. Brazier knew the importance of church buildings, but his vision was to build people for the kingdom of God.
One of the things that I said when I became the pastor is that I'm not just the pastor of the living, I'm also the pastor of the unborn, which means that our vision has to be for them.
When he's talking about the legacy and preparing the church for generations to come, he's already thinking 20 years down the road. And so he's not focusing on building buildings anymore. He's focusing on building people.
I am Lord, all by myself.
Doc is talking about understanding who you are as a child of God and knowing what those great and precious promises mean to you individually. Doc's mission is to make sure that we trust in the truth that has been given to us and that we exercise that authority that the Bible says we have.
For 45 years, evangelist Mary Brazier has been by Dr. Brazier's side, and as First Lady, she knows the importance of ministry, and she gives her total support to her husband.
The role I play as wife is to be what the Bible calls a helpmeet, to support Dr. Brazier, to make sure that he has everything that he needs in order to be able to give to the people of God.
It is the church that survives. It is the people that survive. It is our children and our children's children. We can build buildings, but the church, the people, must be built and must be maintained. And that is what legacy vision is all about.
Dr. Brazier is the type of pastor who is going to make sure that everything Bishop Brazier built and the things that the Lord has called him to continue to build will exist for the generations and generations to come.
The previous two generations of this church left a foundation for us to build on. We inherited the legacy that God put in them. We inherited that. What we do now is to build for the next set of generations still to come.
We are gearing up for a whole new set of people who come into this area who may be from out of town or some from somewhere else. His leadership has been geared toward the future. Change is, you know, is difficult. If you don't change, you will be left in the dust. And so we've changed through all our leadership. We change. And I'm ready for the change.
For 90 years, God has shown himself faithful to this five-generational church. What an amazing celebration. 90 years of giving God all the praise and all the glory as he continues to bestow his blessings upon the people. Though there is still so much more in store, we continue to celebrate this amazing and historic legacy of vision, grace, and truth call, the Apostolic Church of God.
It is a place that is indeed special to God. It is special to this city. It is special to the world. There is nowhere on earth like the Apostolic Church of God.
In the 90 years that we celebrate the grace of God, we celebrate the mercy that he has had on us. This is a work of grace. It's a work of the Holy Spirit that is done through the body. So if you're talking about 90 years, it's not the 90 years of leadership. It's the 90 years that the body has worked together to continue to move down a path of harmony and unity. That is what we celebrate in the 90 years.
How many are ready to give God great praise?